so give us one more try.
Was bright, quite alright. I know that you're lost, 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 but you're gonna be more, more, more afraid that you're not, not good enough. But I'm gonna tell you that I can see you shimmer. I can see you shimmer. It's alright. Yeah, I can see you shimmer. Just like that, all my world turned into dust. Cause you thought there's nobody you could trust. It's so manic, but don't panic. It's a long way to go. Know that you're lost, lost, lost. But you're gonna be more, more, more afraid that you're not, not good enough. But I'm gonna tell you that I can see you shimmer. That I can see you shimmer. I can see you shimmer. I can see you shimmer. It's alright. Yeah, I can see you shimmer.
Now is it wrong or is it right? I'm so trying, trying, trying. It took a whole lot of energy to get me here.
Am I good enough to make it all the way up? A whole lot of energy to get me here. Did I give up on this dream? Or double down on it? A whole lot of energy to get me here. Now is it wrong or is it right? I'm still trying, trying. A whole lot of energy to get me here. Yeah, yeah. Should I fall and fall in line so I can make it out alive? A whole lot of energy to get me here. It's gonna take a whole lot more to get where I wanna be. Do I got what it takes? Eat everybody. Got a whole lot of energy to get me here. Now do I got the strength? Fall and rise again. Got a whole lot of energy to get me here. Now is it wrong or is it right? I'm so trying, trying, trying. Got a whole lot of energy to get me here. Yeah, yeah. Should I fall and can make it out alive. A whole lot of energy to get me here is gonna take a whole lot more to get where I wanna be.
Safe for too long. If I can't choke it out, it's growing too strong for me. It made me proud to hurt you like that. I feel so good about it. Send me your blood, the kind that I like, and I shouldn't be around it. Now it's back again. Got me in the end. You'll be the death of me.
I am a fairy tale. I am a I'm made of love and I can break hearts of steel. I am an old, old song stuck in your head. I am the first to light and the happiest. As long as I got my travel guitar, travel guitar, travel guitar, I'm up in the clouds and up in the stars, and I'm playing on a travel guitar. And I'm playing on a travel guitar. I'm on a mountain, I'm sitting on the beach. The world is turning and it's turning into melodies. I am the little things surrounding me. I am the breathing in and the release. As long as I got my travel guitar, travel guitar, travel guitar, I'm up in the clouds and up in the stars, and I'm playing on a travel guitar. Travel guitar. I'm playing on a travel guitar. I'm playing on travel guitar.
I keep on driving even though I know I'm tired. Pick up your groceries though I don't wanna cook. Discuss my feelings in the middle of the night, all for you. You know that I would lie for you, baby. I walk a thousand miles for you, baby. Play dirtier and lie for you, baby. Believe in things I don't believe, tell you things that I don't need. Everything along the ways, how you say things that we say. It's not about dishonesty, it's about the melody. Always there for me when I need an opinion. Though I will go ahead and do the opposite. And when I'm losing, you just tell me that I'm winning. All for me. You know that I will try for you, baby. I'll walk a thousand miles for you, baby. Play dirty and lie for you, baby. Truth about it, honestly, is we see things we wanna see. Ooh. Everything along the ways, how we say things that we say. Ooh. It's not about dishonesty, it's about the melody. It's about the melody.
Hey guys, welcome back to AI Tuesdays. Today is a very special episode where we will be showcasing what we have learned throughout the weeks in machine learning. So now we will be seeing machine learning in action, and this will be the last episode of machine learning. So we have Narcisse and Bukeka as our teachers today. So that's going to be fun. I can't wait to see you guys do your thing. How are you doing?
I'm good, and you?
I'm good. Good.
Good.
Where is Bukeka?
She's right there.
Okay.
Hey, Bukeka, are you there? I think she's experiencing difficulties.
Probably, yeah. Mm. So, what will you be doing for us today?
Today I want to focus more on the demos where we put everything that we've learned in action, and hopefully we get to that. But before that, I would like to also do a small theory on machine learning API, ML.NET API. So I want to cover that, and then we do a lot of demos, putting everything that we've learned so far into action. And Bukeka will also be showing us how to use ML.NET on Azure. I started it last week, but she's going to continue more examples and practicals so that people can have that reassurance when they're getting to know machine learning. So hopefully it's the last episode today. Putting it in
question marks. Let's hope so. Let's hope so. So take it away.
Bukeka, you ready to start?
Yeah, I think she's having network problems.
Okay, I think I must just go ahead and start until she can come through. That's what I'll do. Bukeka, I'll just start because of time. Is that okay? But yeah.
You can put it in the chat if there's something wrong.
I'll do that. Can you see my screen?
Not yet.
Okay, let me share it. And please keep track of time for me. I'd really appreciate that.
You know me and time.
Okay, cool. So our famous logo. Okay.
Our logo.
Yep, our famous logo. So, machine learning in action by myself, Narcisse Mbuyu, and Bukeka Mososela, if I spelled the name correctly. So, today the content we're going to cover is we're going to look at what is ML.NET API and how does it work. We're going to get started with GitHub, and we're going to look at some cool demos that we're going to use to practice and enhance our knowledge in machine learning. So the big question, the million dollar or the big question is, what is ML.NET API? So we've been talking about this for the past 2 weeks, and we haven't really took a look at what is it in detail, more specifically. So before we talk about what is, we talked about ML.NET, right? But before we talk about what is ML.NET API, we first have to understand what is an API. So an API is an application programmable interface, or in other people call it application programming interface. I prefer programmable. I don't know about others. Application programmable interface. So basically, it's a tool given to developers that allows us to do many functions without even considering what is happening in the background. So for example, let's put it in a scenario. Let's think of an API like a menu in a restaurant, right? So we go to a restaurant, your Wimpy, your McDonald's, your Steers, you know, they give you the menu for you to look at, right? The menu, it provides a list of dishes or orders that, of certain foods that you can order, along with the description on of each on the side. So when we look at the order, right, the menu, we see all these things written on it. So when we specify what we want from the menu, the restaurant does the work for us. They go and cook the food, they serve the food to us, and all we do is just eat, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what an API basically is in simple terms. It's a set of tools offered to us that we can use it however we want, whenever we want, in whatever scenario we want, and all the backend work is done for us. So that is what an API is. Do you understand it, Leto?
Yeah, I actually do. That example makes it way easier. But I have a question. Are you going to be creating, because I know that some people create their APIs from scratch. So will you be one of those people?
Yes, I have to say. People can learn how to do it. So basically, this episode is now caters for those advanced people in machine learning. You know, throughout the episode, we've gone up the ladder from starting from the basic, not knowing anything. We've touched for those who don't know how to program, for those who are in the middle, and now we are catering for those who are experts in the field of ML. So yeah.
Would you say that you are an expert? It's an expert.
Well, I'll put myself in between. I'm learning as well.
Cool.
Learning. So continuing. ML. So now we know what is an API, right? Application Programmable Interface. Now we're going to look at what is ML.NET API. So basically, ML.NET API is a set of tools that are offered by Microsoft. I'm sorry about that, the background noise.
Nope.
1 minute, let me just mute my mic. Okay, the noise is over. So basically, ML.NET API, right, is a set of tools offered by Microsoft, is a set of API tools offered by Microsoft that allows us to enhance or put machine learning capabilities in our softwares, most specifically in our .NET applications. .NET applications. So you're looking at your C#, your F#, your Xamarin, your web applications, your console application. We are able to put machine learning capabilities inside our application using an API, and all of this with this API, we're going to be building it from scratch. Basically, have a code first approach, starting from the basics, starting from nothing, without any interface or any help. We're starting from nothing from scratch. So that's what basically ML.NET API is.
Oh, cool. That's
so. If you have a question, you can just stop me.
Yeah,
So what are the key elements of ML.NET API, right? So ML.NET API starts off with an ML context. What is an ML context? An ML context is basically an object. Now, I'm using these big words, objects and stuff like that, but on Azure.NET Friday, hopefully this week, they're going to go more on to OOP, right? Object-oriented programming. But we're not going to look at that for the scope of today's episode. So basically, an object is like the middleman between the application and the class or the API itself. An API can also be considered as a class because it does the work in the backend. So the object is like the middleman transferring the information between the class and the actual application itself. So it starts off with an ML context. So the ML context is a singleton object containing catalogs. Now I'm going into more big words, so hopefully you pay attention and understand what I'm saying. So basically, a singleton object, right, is a class that is made to do everything in one class. So for example, when we're dealing with OOP, we have a class that for this instance, let's use what we have on the screen, for example. So we got saving and loading data, preparing our data, training algorithms, and using our model. So basically, in a normal OOP environment, we're going to have to create a class for this one. We're going to have to create a class for this one. We're going to have to create a class for this one. We're going to have to create a class for this one. Isn't that right, Leto?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes. But now, with a singleton object, all these functions are in one single class. We don't have to create a lot of classes for everything. Everything is in one single class ready for us to use. So that is a singleton object. Everything is there. And now I mentioned catalogs. So basically, catalogs, there are methods that provide or enable one to perform a variety of different operations or functions that we need to build our machine learning pipelines. So inside the singleton object, or inside the class, right, we have something called catalogs. And all these four that I've just mentioned are example of catalogs that basically methods or that enables us or helps us when we're using our machine learning capabilities. So yeah, that's how it basically works. So singleton class, a singleton object under the ML context object, and then under all of that, we have all these catalogs within it. So that's a simple way to put it. Moving on. So the first step when we're dealing with ML.NET API, right, we have to get our data. So ML.NET offers us to get our data from different places and offers a lot of capabilities in that regards. So like I said, it's a code-first approach. We are not using any functions. We're not using anything. We have to do everything by ourselves, and we have to do everything in a logical and specified order, right? So we can get our data from a single file and multiple files in directories. So basically, two files in different locations. We can get it from a database, like over here, a data source, or we can also get it from in-memory collection. Basically, the data is stored in the RAM, in the random access memory, and then you're able to collect it. So that's the first step, getting our data. And I've just provided the different options where we can get our data. And here's an example of the code of how it's going to look like. Right? And after getting our...
Okay, can I have a question?
Yeah?
Please go back to the previous slide.
Okay.
Okay, so you say that we can get our data from different locations, right?
Yes.
So will the code only have one location, or can it have like let's say you see the code for online 5, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's say now you want to code something, and will you have to only use that line, or can you use multiple data sources? Like where you have your data from?
So for this line over here, it only specifies that we're getting our data from one location. As you can even see in the name, my data file.csv, this is one, this is where the data source is, a CSV file. So that's where we're getting our source from, right? And then this other lines of code, we're gonna look at it one when we're doing the demo, right? But now if we look at this one, load data from multiple files, right? So we're saying load from file. This is the first file, the first source that we're getting. And then if we want to add a second source, we're going to use the same line but put a different location.
Ah, okay.
You see, like, for example, yeah, there's each other, a more practical example. You see, load from data one, subfolder 1.txt, and then subfolder 2.txt. So those are the two different locations.
Cool.
You see that? Cool.
Yeah.
So what's happening? What's happening to my slide? Okay. So I'll have to do first so we can get into the demos. So we have data models and schema, right? So now after loading our data, what we have to do, we have to load it into something called a data view, right? So a data view is another catalog or another object that we're gonna be using. And what's the function of this data view is to transform our data, Basically, it transforms or loads our data into a format that can be understood and processed so that the machine learning process can take place. So we are putting names of people, we are putting prices and stuff like that. All of that cannot be understood for machine learning to take place. So it has to be transferred, it has to be transformed in a way that it's able to be interpreted for machine learning to take place. And that's, in order for that to take place, we use a data view object. And last week we spoke about pipelines. Pipelines are basically a step-by-step procedure in order for us to execute machine learning processes. For example, you know, when you're building in plumbing, you got this pipe to do this, we got that pipe to do that, we got that pipe to do that. It's the same thing with machine learning. So in this pipe, we want this function to be done, and then in that pipe, we want this function to be done, and we put it together, we got a whole process. You get that ideology behind it.
Yeah. Sorry, there was a noise in the background. I couldn't hear you properly.
Which part?
About pipelines.
So basically pipelines, right? Pipelines, as I've said, let me close the windows.
Sorry, Leto.
Yes, we can hear you now, Bukeka.
Okay, thank you.
Is she back?
Yep.
Okay, let me quickly finish and then I'll pass it over to her. So as I was saying, right, pipelines, right? We spoke about pipelines last week. So pipelines let's put it in a plumbing context, right? So in plumbing, we got this pipe to do this, to transfer water from this place to that place. We got another pipe to transfer to this function. And then all together, we put it together, we got a whole piping system, right? And it's the same thing with pipelines in machine learning. This pipe will do a certain thing, this pipe will do a certain thing, and we put it together. So that's what pipelines are in machine learning, to do a certain function, and all together we put it together to achieve a certain goal. I think that's
cool.
Yeah. So that's basically data views. It helps us to transform our data into a format that can be understood for machine learning to take place, and it gets put into the pipelines. So yeah, okay, moving on. So after loading our data, we have to prepare our data. And we don't need to do that. All we can use is called this method, data operation catalog. So we just put this namespace in our code, and we're able to do all of this. It's able to filter data, replace missing values, use normalizers, work with text data, and work with categorical data. So we have to filter and process our data so that we can get accurate result. And you know, we don't need to do it manually. We will just use this function, as I mentioned earlier, to do it for us. At the end of that processing, right, there's something called a iData view. We're gonna take a look at that when doing the demo. iData view basically tabulizes our data so that it can be used when machine learning. So it gets all these bits of data from our file source and puts it together in one table so that it can be used. So yeah, I'm almost finished. So now this is an example of a pipeline, right? So I don't want to spend too much time. I've already spent too much time on the slides. So basically, this is an example of a pipeline. As you can see, the first line 2 tells us that we want to predict a label, and where is that label coming from fair amount in the table source. And now these are other input columns that will help us predict this fair amount. And all of this is an example of a pipeline. And there is a data view. So after processing our data, we put it in a data view in one table so that we can use it. Please, if I'm too fast, you must just let me know, because I'm rushing because of time.
Not really. I mean, we're rushing against time here, so understand.
Okay, cool. But if I don't understand, you must just let me know.
Cool. So you code your own pipeline so that they can give you an output, right?
Yes, to basically put in our data and put it out in a format that can be used for machine learning. So that's what the pipeline is for, basically.
Now I want to see the outcome of this demo.
So there is it. After putting our data in, we have to evaluate it. So in order for us to, what do I mean by evaluate? We have to check how well it performed. So we're gonna put in a certain algorithm for it to use. For example, there's no algorithms mentioned of it. Or there is it, ML context.regression. So it used the regression algorithm to train this data. And after all, the metrics, it uses the metrics to give it a performance score of how well it trained. So the higher the metrics, the better the result's going to be. And we took a look at that last week. So if you are not paying attention or miss some episodes, please go back because it will help you to get where we are right now. So now after doing that, we have to save our model, right? So after creating our model, we have to save it because this model runs in memory, meaning that if we close our application, if we close our model, we're going to lose everything, all the training data that we have. So we have to save it somewhere. You can either save it on the model, on your local machine in the same folder, as you can see over here, or you can save it remotely if you are dealing with servers online. So, yeah.
Oh, cool.
And then after that, you can use your model to make predictions. Now, this is something called a prediction engine. So after we've done all our preparation, we now call our prediction engine to train our data, to train our data for what we wanted to do. So a prediction engine will only train the data once. But if you want to train your data more than once, then you have to create something called a prediction engine pool. As you can see, a prediction engine pool will allow us to train our data more than once because a prediction engine doesn't support threads, meaning that we cannot put a lot of things at once. But with a prediction engine pool, we are able to put a lot of things so that we can train our data.
Yeah. Okay. So a prediction is more like, you know, the word in its sense, like to predict that something will be the output, or how does that work?
Yes, you're absolutely right. So prediction, as you've just said, is to predict or output what we want to find out. For example, we want to find out the price. So it's going to predict the price based on the values that we've given, based on the data that we've given it to train. So that's what it basically means.
All right.
So basically, to put everything that I've just said in a diagram for those who like diagrams, so it's like a cycle. We collect our data and train it, and we put it in an R data view. Then we create our pipelines. After creating our pipeline, we train our model using a certain algorithm, and then we improve our model, evaluate. If we're happy with the score, we can save it. After saving, we can load it and make prediction. So basically, this is a diagram format. So with that being said, it's time for demos.
Awesome.
I'm going to pass it over to Bukeka so she can do her part. And then awesome. We'll do demos.
Okay, so please can you give me the control to share the screen?
Yeah, you can share your screen.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to create an account on Azure.
An account on Azure?
Like, okay, for a student who doesn't have an account with Azure, Microsoft Azure. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so you go to Azure. I mean, for me, because I already have an account, so this is the, okay, so you go to Azure, and then wait, and then you go here to Microsoft Azure.
Bukeka?
Is it frozen?
I think so.
Oh my, let me let her know.
I think the network is giving an issue.
Yeah.
Bukeka. Okay, I think her network is really troubling her. But because of time, I think I must step in.
Okay. Are you also prepared for the demo?
Can we?
Yeah. I have some things in store.
Machine learning, and then
I heard her.
Sorry.
Hello. You froze. So. I don't know if you know. No.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so you go and create your workspace. You first create your resource group, and then you create a machine learning workspace. And then it will take you here. When you come here, you will see a lot of options where you can choose which one you wanted to create. So now, since we're doing machine learning, we're going to go and create a new automated machine learning. And then, so we're going to start. This is how we're going to do. So what you will need data that is going to be formatted on CSV. So I advise you to go and download the data on Kaggle. This is the website that I use to download my data. So you can also use it and download your own data. Okay. So you create a new machine learning. Okay. So when you're here, you have to create a data set of which way is it allows you to come and upload the data that you want to upload. So you're going to go and say create data set. And then you're going to say, because mine, I'm going to be uploading it from my computer, so I'm gonna say from local files, and I'm gonna say I'm gonna specify the name that I want to use. So for me, I want to use, okay, my data is about banking, so I'm gonna use bank info. Why? Because I already have a bank info already. And then you can also describe which are, like, you can just say, state the description of the one that you want to use. So it's bank information for me. Okay, then you say next. Okay, so yeah, we choose the one, like, so we're gonna choose the connection, the storage where you're gonna use. We basically use Azure Blob Storage because we are working on Azure. And then now you're gonna upload the file that you want to it to be available on Azure. Okay. So as I said, I'm using bank information. So here's my file. It has to be saved in CSV. Otherwise, if it's not saved in CSV, it's gonna give you errors, and you're not gonna be able to continue with uploading your data. Okay, say next. So it takes the time, but now you're gonna have to just wait, like, it's loading here. This is the percentage. So you just have to wait just a little bit. Okay. Okay.
So
yes.
So sorry about that. So everything also Bukeka is doing, if you really don't understand as she's going so fast because of time, you can always catch last week's episode where we went through this in detail. What Bukeka is doing is everything done in detail last week. So that's just a heads up. You may continue, Bukeka.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so when you're here, you want to specify the details or the settings of how you want your data to be viewed. So since I have column 1, 2, 3, I don't want it to be column 1. I want the exact columns that I want, like, so the headers that I have specified, since we have age, job, marital education. So I want it come like this, not as column 1. So I'm gonna come here, column headers, and I'm gonna select all file headers header. Okay, and there we have age, job, marital, and then education. Okay, and then I'm gonna say next. So here you can specify which column you want it to appear when you're viewing your data. So I do need age because on this example, what we're basically looking for is we want to search, or we want to predict how many people will select a fixed account or when they are banking with the bank that we are using. So we do obviously need the name, then the job name. So yeah, but then we can take this out the day of the week because we don't need the day.
Sorry,
of the week.
Bukeka, sorry to disturb you. So remember, please go back if you can. Please, yeah. So what I want to know is, from the table of data that we have there, did you have to manually store each and every column? or was it, how did that happen?
Okay, for me, I didn't manually store the data. So this is the data that I found. So if the bank was like, if I was working at the bank, so I needed to call about 100 people to find out if they will be choosing a fixed savings for their banking, then I will have to store it manually, call each person. But now, because this data is already stored for us, as I have mentioned that we can download this data here on this website here, you can just come here and choose which data you want to use. Like, they have a lot of data. You can use Netflix, Stroke. It's up to you which one you want to choose.
Okay, so I think we didn't see that part because your screen froze. So
okay, sorry about that. Okay, sorry. So yeah, so we have, then you can choose which, that's it. You can choose which column you want it to appear, and then we continue. Okay, so now we have our data set, we have created it. So let's continue to create. So it basically takes time for it to create. Okay, so here it is. So now we want to like configure our okay. So if so now we want to configure our data. So you say you come here to configure, and then you can view the information that you have put, like the information that you have already uploaded. This is the information that we uploaded. Okay. And then we can create a, like, you now have to create the bank experiment. So if you have already created one, I have already created one, so I'm going to choose one. But if you haven't created one, you can come to this option and say create, and then you can specify the name that you want. And then, so since I have one, I'm just going to come here and say bank experiment. And then here, so we wanted to see like which people, if how many people can choose to use a fixed savings. So we're going to, our targeted column is going to be yes, where we ask, can you choose fixed or not, yes or no. So we're going to specify here. And then again, we have to set the computer class.
I'm sorry. I have another question. So if I want to create a new experiment name, will it be the same procedure as like how you're doing when you already have an existing one, or will it be different? Can you please take us through that one, maybe? Maybe not, you know, save that. We just want to see if the column, I mean, if the new experiment name, target column, select compute cluster is still the same, or will it be different for when you're creating a new experiment?
It will be like, okay, so when you're creating a new experiment name, your experiment name has to be a new one. You can also say it's bank info. Like,
okay. So I'm asking if when you're creating a new one, will it be like the same procedure as when you already have an existing one? Or
no, sorry. So no, it's not gonna be the same procedure. When you have the existing one, you're just gonna select the one that, if maybe I had 4 hours, gonna have a drop list of 4 of them. But if you don't have one, you have to choose a new one and make sure that it's not the same as the one that already exists. Like, we don't do duplication. I don't know if that answers your question.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can choose. And then also with the computer cluster, you can create a new one if you don't have one. And then you can choose. Okay. And then you can choose based on your computer. And then you can choose based on your computer the location, machine size. If your computer has bigger size, they can then choose more size. Like, you've given like an option to choose which data you want to use, like the vision machine type and the size. So it's up to you which one you want to choose. But I have already created one. So
can you please tell us about what a virtual machine is?
So basically, for me, a virtual machine is when you want to have a separate space from your main computer. It gives you an extra memory, like it gives you more memory than your original computer.
Oh, cool. It makes the process more smoother.
Yes, it makes, like, when you're using, like, if I was using virtual machine right now, I'm definitely sure my process was going to be faster than it is right now. Because it allows you to choose, like, you want how, like, the processor size, the memory size, like, you're creating your own computer, but in the same computer.
Oh, okay.
Okay, then can I say next? And then here, so because we want to predict, so this is, like, we want to predict one or several things. So we wanted to predict the people that will choose fixed savings. So this is the option that we're going to choose. And then I'm going to come here. So we going to choose the best configuration that we know now. So I'm going to choose AUC. And then here, when you are here at the exit criteria, you specify like how long you want your machine to run. So I want my machine to stop after 1 hour. And then validation, you also choose like the validation type you want to use. So we're going to use K4 cross validation, and then we're going to, like, based on your notes in your computer, you can then choose. You can also leave this blank if your notes on the computer are like you have less. So it's up to you, also depending on the computer. So I'm going to choose 5. And then, yeah.
Okay, can you please also tell us what AUC weighted metric is? What is an AUC weighted metric?
Okay, so basically,
So basically, you saw earlier on when I was talking about the type of metrics we can use. AUC metric is a type of metric that is used to calculate or give a certain score to the model that is being used or being trained. So remember, I said like the higher the higher the percentage, the higher the accuracy of the results would be. So the AUC is a type of metric or model that based on the algorithm that is used to determine the score or the percentage of the model being tested. Okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
Thank you, Narcisse. It does. Okay. So, and then we're going to choose the visualization setting. You don't really have to choose much. So, if maybe here you had your age, it was maybe 25.2, and you don't want it to be 25.2, you can just go here and then say mean, and then it will give you the exact value you want. And then also here, if your age is in date time, you can change it and then make it to be numeric. Like, you can't have an age which is 02/045. So you basically change the features that you want it to be here. And then we say finish. Okay, so yeah, like, this machine takes longer. So it shows you here, it hasn't started running at all. So it hasn't, like, it's not working at the moment. It doesn't exist on Azure. So since I was working on it, I'm gonna show you the one that is already working, but it's also not finished as yet. So this is now the machine learning that we have uploaded. So we still need it, like, all the data that we have to be like executed, and then we can also see what we need. So now we can't really predict the result that we want because our mission is not completed as yet. So these are the models that we have already managed to upload. Like I did this about an hour and a half ago, but it's still not finished. So it tells you like this is not a thing. It shows you the AUC weight, the AUC weighted. Yeah, it took, and then it also shows you that it how long it took, the duration, and then it also shows you that it's completed or it's still running or it's in the queue. Okay, so because I can't show you, I can't explain, because the model that I have to explain in, it's not here, it's voting, so it's not yet uploaded. You can also, okay, let's just create, click here. So if I want my model to be deployed, see, this is where the explanation comes, where it shows you the results of the prediction that you have predicted, but now since it hasn't come, we can't say. So you can also deploy your model without having to code. You can just say the name that you want it to be here by the name. But I'm not gonna deploy mine because I do not have much credit, so I can't deploy mine. So you come here and then say the name, and then you can explain that it's banking information, and then the computing type that you want it to use, Azure Container Instance, where you can store your data, and then yeah, you can just put the name where people will be seeing where they search your model, and then you can continue to deploy.
I see.
And that's it. But now, since we don't have the model that we want, I can't. But
we can see that. Like I have a finished example that we did last week. I can always show it to people to see how it's gonna look like after it's done.
All right, please do that. Sure. Mine is still running.
Because you put it for 1 hour, I put my one for like 10 minutes.
I didn't. Again, I'm suspicious. The complete.
Okay, I will show it just now. But any questions for Leto, for Bukeka?
For me, no, I don't have any questions at all. I feel like I did understand part of it, but then there would have been more questions if there was like an actual like deployment that was done, you know. But then yeah, I asked the question throughout the things that I really needed to know about the AUC, what it does. So yeah, let's see what you have, and maybe some questions will come up.
Okay, cool. Thank you for that, Bukeka. Thank you. It was really insightful.
Thanks.
So on my side, I will show what Bukeka is doing. I will get to that. That's as you are. But for now, I'll no problem, Bukeka. Really, you do understand. So we're going to continue the practical, the demos. So what I have over here is Visual Studio, as you can see, and I also have our folder. So for today's session, we're gonna make a temperature forecaster. It's gonna predict the temperature of a certain location over a period of time. We're gonna check if our text that we have is whether it's a spam or a ham. A spam, you know, those spam texts that are there to annoy you, and ham are those type of text that you actually wanna read. They're not like really of an annoyance. And then we're gonna check the sentiment of people's Twitter text. So people's tweets, we're gonna see how those people are feeling. We're gonna predict it, and we're also gonna check the foods, the object. This is object detection. We're gonna train the machine learning to predict what type of food is shown in the picture. And awesome. For the API, we're going to focus on an old project, which is going to predict the price of a cab ride. It's going to predict.
Well, let's see, we have like 15 minutes. Do you think we can cover all those things in 15 minutes?
Yeah, we can, because most of them is under training. So we're just going to put it, activate it, and then put it in the background. And then we're going to focus on the API. So the first one is going, you're going to do is open your Visual Studio. And which one must you start with, Leto?
This starts with the spam. No, this is it. Sentiment.
The sentiment. Yeah.
Yeah.
It detects what type of tweet, how the people were feeling, what type of sentiment those people had when they're making those tweets. So you're gonna name our project, and then create. So we are using .NET Core. All these machine learning functions are under .NET Core. If you go back to framework, you won't really have it. So there is it, our default Hello World application. So on Azure and .NET Friday last week, they were telling us how to navigate through the C# world and with .NET Core application. But I won't go through that. I'll just come to my Solution Explorer, right click, and go to add. Can you see the screen, Leto?
Yep, I can. Maybe if you just zoom in a little.
Okay, cool. Magnifier. Okay. So I come here to Solution Explorer. Can you see what are you seeing exactly?
I'm seeing, can you please minimize the magnifier? Thank you.
Like that.
Okay.
So Solution Explorer, and then right click, I come to add. And then add machine learning, right?
Mm-hmm.
Machine learning. And then after that, it's going to look like this. It's going to give us an option of what type of machine learning we want to do. So we got, So we got text classification. We got text classification, value prediction, image classification, recommendation, and anomaly detection, forecasting, clustering, and object detection. So now what we're going to do is, we said sentiment. So in order for us to predict the sentiment, it's going to be this one, text classification. Yeah. So we can choose to run it on our virtual machine, as Bukeka was saying. But now for this, we're going to run it on my local machine, because I think my baby can handle it. we choose our file. And then we go to the file that we downloaded, and we say sentiment. And there's it there. So my data source that I have here, I downloaded from the same website that Bukeka was showing us.
What?
Kaggle. Yes, Kaggle. Mm-hmm. Let me show you just for purpose-wise. So there's it, yeah. So this website, you can download a lot of data sources that you can use to test your project. So this is where I got mine for today's purpose. So here is it. Our data has been loaded. So if we quickly check, we see we got tweets over there. We got the people who tweeted it, the date and time, and the query. So those are the columns. So now what we're trying to predict is I think I made a mistake somewhere. We can actually predict what type of sentiment they had.
Isn't it the last one? Can't that be the last one?
No, this is the actual tweet itself.
Uh-huh. But what are we predicting? We're predicting how they were feeling when they wrote that tweet.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, I think for this one, I'm going to have to do a checkup on this one.
Yeah.
I have to do a checkup on this one.
But maybe if you try that one, the last column.
The last column.
Yeah, let's just try that one.
Okay. So we select the type of the column that we're trying to predict, right? And after that, we put our input columns. So we got these are the headers of our column. we got zero. You see, it really doesn't make sense. So it's really quite confusing. I think we must come back to this one for the because of time. Focus on something that makes more sense. Again, you open your Visual Studio, file, open, new project, open your console application, and I'm gonna have to go really fast. So now we're gonna create a spam or a ham. So there is it, it's been created. Follow the same process again, spam or ham, add machine learning, and then I think text classification, it's we're supposed to use it for spam and ham. Spam and ham. So because it makes sense to for us to categorize it. So you see, guys, the importance of choosing your correct scenario in order for which for you to work with. And last time we chose the wrong scenario, and that's why it gave us problem. So for example, this one we want to predict what type of category it falls under. Does it fall under ham or spam? So we're gonna choose category, and we're gonna look at the type of message that it is. So we're gonna enter a message, and it's gonna tell us what type of category it falls under. So we're gonna start training for 10 seconds, or in 10 seconds, yeah. 10 seconds, but the higher the training time, the better. As you can see here, if you train it for the minimum training time is 10 minutes, but yeah, we just, because of time. So you see, we have to train it for a bit more because it wasn't enough. But 10 seconds, 10 minutes is how many seconds? Now it's back to max. Let's continue with the other. Let's continue because of time. Let's do a temperature forecaster. It predicts the temperature, right? Add new project again. So we're basically doing demos. So while that's being done in the background, we're focusing on this one. Next, temperature forecast. Temperature forecast. Then create. So solution, add, and I'm repeating this until it gets stuck in your in people's heads. So we want to forecast the temperature. So forecast, where is forecast? Value prediction. Is it the right scenario? Predict value prediction prices. Yeah, it's value prediction, predicting the weather of a certain environment. We're gonna choose our file, and then our file is date. It is the weather temperature in certain cities. It's loading. So we got Africa, Algeria, the cities, the month and the year, and the average temperature. So we're gonna want to predict the average temperature. The average temperature, right? And now let's be specific. What region, country? Do we need state? I don't think so. We need state.
No.
City, the city of Durban, maybe. And the month or year. The month, year, and date. I think we will need those ones. So we're gonna predict the weather based on that.
Oh, why is the year so far back?
Yeah, so like the more data you feed it, the accurate it will become. So we're looking from 1995 up until today, and then we're gonna predict, because we have to give it a nice range for it to work with. You get what I'm saying? So over here it's the 1800 seconds. So let's just train it. Boy. We do not want to wait for that long. 20-30 minutes to train. Let's put it as 500 seconds.
What's it saying?
It's saying that they're giving us the criteria. 500 seconds is not enough to train. So they said,
so you have to train 10 minutes to 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Whoa, you have to train. Yeah. So for 30 minutes, you'll be training it.
I won't put 10 minutes. So 600. 600 yeah. seconds. Because of time, eyeball. Okay, fine. Yep. Eyeball. So you see? Yeah, it's going. It's managed to accept. So the higher your data, the more training time it'll be. So we're training it for 9 minutes. 10 minutes.
Will we see this one? Will we see it next week?
I think we've got time. I think we'll get time. But let's look at the other one. You have so many Visual Studio open, I don't know which one is which. So which one are we working on? Hi, Bo. I closed the other one. I closed the other one for the what is it again? The spam or ham. How did I close it? Okay. Time is our worst enemy right now.
There's like 3 minutes left, I think.
Yeah, we're wrapping up just now. So let's go to our folder where we have our Visual Studio file, users, SpireSway, sources, so far to just to get an app. Can you imagine?
just create a shortcut or something.
Nah, I like my stuff organized.
Oh, wow. Okay.
spam or ham. Let us open that one.
So you've already done and tested them?
Apparently, we have to start again because it's what? Yeah, we have to start again because it got canceled. Got canceled. Spam or ham, but let me do it quickly because so people can see results of what we are trying to do. Machine learning. So now I know next time that I must open a new Visual Studio from scratch, not from this one. Otherwise, it's gonna close. PC, don't fail me now. So because I'm running the test in the background now, my PC is becoming slow.
Yep, should have created a virtual machine.
No, my baby can handle it. I trust it.
But, okay.
So there we go. We want to predict the category. The message is there and the train. So let us put it for how many seconds? 120. So it's training for 2 minutes. So let's do one more test before we end off the show.
You have a minute to do that.
Okay, can we end it for 5 past, if that's okay, host?
Okay, I mean, you told me to be the timekeeper too, so I'm just telling you that an hour is about to finish.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. Okay, so... Okay, thank you. So we're doing those two tests in the background, right? I think the others we're gonna leave for in the next episode. But with that being said, I just want to show you the other one that I'm working on. The API, the API that we're talking about. Where is it? Okay, there's it, yeah. So this is the API I was working on. I wanted to show you how it is, how it looks like, but because of time, you're gonna have to postpone it for next week. And I really don't like this. But, so this is what I wanted us to do today, right? So basically, this, what we're doing, right? It's being done for us. We don't need to do any code at all. It's being done for us. And now what I'm showing you here is being we're doing it from scratch. You see what we're training in the back, and we're doing it everything from scratch. We're telling it how to train and everything like that. So the first things first, what I did, right? You first had to go to your NuGet manager, right? So your NuGet manager, for those who don't know, is a place where you can get extra APIs. We spoke about APIs, and these are all APIs. So you come here, manage NuGet manager, and it opens this. And then you search ml.net, ml.net, right? ml.net, and then it gives you the result and you have to download it. So this is the one we're working with. You download it here. There's a black part to download it. I've already downloaded, that's why it's X. Download it, download. So we download ml.net and FastTree for what we're gonna be using. So after downloading it, we name it in our namespace using Microsoft ML and using MIO. So after that, right, what was the first step we had to do? We had to input our data, as you can see, input our data. So the first step that we did over here is put the training data, the data that we're gonna use, private static, you know, training data part, with putting the location for where we're getting our data. The same thing for the test data. And after training it, this part over here is to save our data in that specific location, right? And then after training our data, we now create our pipelines. Our pipelines is here. So basically, over here, I created another class to put our input data, all the input columns. You see, when we are selecting our input columns in the other ones, we're doing it here in a specific class. And then there's also one for output. So we put our input columns and the output column, the one that we're trying to predict, and then we're gonna use it here in the pipelines, right? I'm just explaining fast because of time, but we're gonna get to it next week in practice. So after putting our pipelines and sorting out our pipeline, we now tell what type of regression, what type of algorithm for it to use. And wanted to use regression, the regression algorithm. There's so many algorithms for us to use, but we decided to use regression. And this, like I said, is for experts. So those experts know what type of algorithm are there and what they can use. But with the training one that we're doing, the artificial intelligence is choosing for us. We're not choosing anything. It's choosing for us based on the data that we have put forward, right? And then after that, we put data view. Data view is to tabulate our data in a format that that can be used for machine learning. And after that, it's now we start to train our data in this column over here, as you can see. So because of time, I'm gonna end there. Let us check our results before my host kills me.
Yep, we are over time.
Okay, so our first result has finished, right? Let's evaluate and predict. So, right, we put a message, go until Joe Rang Crazy available only in, we put a random message, basically. You see? We put a random message and it predicted what type of message it is, ham or spam or ham. And it said 100% ham. It's confident it's a ham. So if we say, hi, let to predict the ham. Because you want to hear it, you see.
Yeah.
So after putting that, we're going to add this project to our code. This did the code. You see, we're going to add the code into our project, and there's it over here. But because of time, we're going to continue next week. And the other one is about to finish. But anyways, guys, you know, I wanted to do a lot of demos for today's session, but because of time, I will end it off here. We're going to continue next week.
Cool. So you can say our goodbyes now.
Yeah, I guess. You're the host. You tell us what to do.
Oh, wow. Tomorrow is a Wednesday. So that's going to be interesting. We're going to be having La Blonde, who is going to be talking about her initiative. And yeah, that's what we're having tomorrow. And our host will be Linche and Nosipo. So that's really exciting because LeBlonde is also one of our own. She's part of MLSA. So that's going to be very fun. Please make sure to join tomorrow's session. And also thank you for joining us today and, you know, getting into ML demos. And we hope that you watch the other previous videos so that you can also do your own ML. In the future, probably. I know I'm going to do mine.
So, yeah, I see.
Thank you very much, Narcisse, and also to Bukeka. I think she's not with us now anymore in the chat.
Bukeka, you there? So,
I don't think she is.
Not there.
Yeah, so I thank you very much, guys. And yeah, we hope to see more next week.
Can I say something before I go?
Sure.
Yeah, the data just finished, so we get to test it.
Oh, my word. Okay.
I'm sorry, folks, but just a quick test. We got Africa, Algeria, and, okay, let's put South Africa. Right, South Africa, and Durban, the city of Durban. And then today's date is the 16th of March. Oh. 16th of March, and yeah, 2030. It's averaging 64.2 degrees Celsius. It's predicting it's gonna be 64 degrees next in 10 years time on today.
Oh.
This day. It's so cool. Okay, but I just
right.
Huh? Hi, but what can we do? It's the data that is speaking based on what's been happening for the past 20 years. It's predicting. But anyways, it is what it is. Global warming.
Yeah.
Sorry?
Mm-hmm. I'm saying it is pretty cool that it can predict something that will happen in like the next 9 years. So, yeah.
See. From my side and Leto, I guess we can say bye-bye. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, and we'll keep in touch for tomorrow in Women in Tech Wednesday. See you.
Cool. Bye.
When I dream, baby, I dream of white sand. We're happier though we ain't even trying.
And when I dream, I'm dreaming of the ocean breeze. We could leave the second word you come with me. Baby, let's get lost somewhere. Long as we keep going, baby, I don't care. Like we ain't got no goals and no destination. Oh, I know I wanna feel the sun somewhere. Let's get lost somewhere. Baby, let's get lost somewhere. Long as we keep going, baby, I don't care. Like we ain't got no goals and no destination. Oh, I know I wanna feel the sun somewhere. Let's get lost somewhere.
Take me out of here. See the light, I got no way to reach it. Like a puzzle where I'm missing some pieces. It may be in our atmosphere, sucking up the love like we're leeches. Everything we do is deceiving. But I got you on my mind. So why are we wasting time? We can do better. We can do better now. We keep on fighting and taking the seeded ground. We can do better. We can still figure out. We can do better until we are safe and sound. So confused, insanity is always repeating, changing all the time like the season. None of us can cut it loose, spending all the time overheated. History is always repeating, but I got you on my mind. So why are we wasting time? We can do better.
We can do better.
We can do. The seeded ground. We can do better.
We can do better now.
We can still figure out. We can do better until we are safe and sound.
We can do better. We can do better now. We keep on fighting. I take it to seeded ground. We can do better. We can still figure out.
We can do better until we are safe. Sound.
Everybody wanna come and